Sometimes I need to machine long pieces of material on my lathe that stick out the back of the headstock. I made a spider with three brass tip screws to support hex and round bar, but now I need to support some square bar. So I'm going to convert the spider to take four screws at 90 degrees as well as three at 120. It'll also make centering round bar much more intuitive, rather like using a forge or chuck. The conversion needs three additional M8 threaded holes. The spider clamps onto the back end of the headstock spindle tube using an M3 clamp screw in a partially separated ring of material cut using a slitting saw. That can remain unchanged. The new setup can still be used as before using three screws. I'll need to make one extra brass tip lock screw. For that I'll be using the lantern chuck I made previously. It'll need a new custom collet machining so it can grip the head and align the shaft of the screw as it's machined to length, drilled, countersunk, and then has the brass head pressed in and skimmed to size. The collets need to be around 16mm OD with an 11mm spigot to fit into the lantern chuck nut. I'll drill it to 8mm internal diameter, although the roll bolts I'm using are actually a little undersized. This is a short section of 5/8 inch CZ121 brass bar, which is 15.8mm nominal. I'll take a light skim of the OD, although it's not strictly necessary. The overall length of the collet's set to the required length under the head of the bolt. I'm using brass for convenience. I would normally use some tool steel or 4140 or similar decent material for any smaller fasteners, but for this big one it doesn't really matter. As my ancient Newall DRO doesn't have individual tool offsets, I need to measure the workpiece rather more frequently. But this Mitutoyo's such a joy to use that I don't care. It's a nice day and nobody's on my case insisting that I reduce cycle times. I recognise it's a very privileged position to be in as a hobby bodger rather than a proper machinist. It looks like that's a decent fit in the 11mm hole in the chuck, so now I'll skim the OD. I'm not bothering with a centre or spot drill. These 8mm Cobalt HSS stub drills are very stiff and self-centre brilliantly. I'll trim the collet to length later, so I'm eyeballing the edge of the body with the right face of the parting tool and zeroing the DRO to set the length of parting off. Not high precision, but good enough for government work.
Rubbish planning as usual. Less than a millimetre of clearance. Neil's an idiot. As you know already, he forgot to press record, so there's no footage of turning the collet to length. Brilliant.
I snipped off most of the excess length of the bolt using a cutting disc on my splendid Milwaukee battery angle grinder. With a lantern chuck mounted in a 20mm collet, I can now square off the bolt to the correct length. I will use a centre drill this time.
Wacky waving inflatable arm flailing tube man. Wacky waving inflatable arm flailing tube man.
Sincere apologies to Al Harrington. I've watched way, way too much Family Guy. That's the bolt end drilled. Next stop's making the brass insert from 10mm CZ121 bar stock. Right, that's a decent fit in the end of the bolt. Hopefully it'll just tap in. I don't want to use the hydraulic press on this. Sorry, Lowry. Parting it off and leaving a little extra material. Mild sigh of relief as it taps in nicely. I used a drop of Loctite as well, belt, braces and bootstraps. I'm facing this to length very, very gently because of course I didn't leave long enough for the Loctite to set. I used a fine file to blend the corners rather than machining it. That's the extra bolt completed. I bought a set of interchangeable magnetic hex bits, so I've got about 20 different options for gripping the screw head. This one's 6mm hex, more detail of that in the lantern chuck video. Off camera I marked up the locations for each of the new holes, scribing a line where I need each bolt to fit. I used a centre finder, sliding square, ruler, scribe and what felt like an excessive number of hands. Before anyone yells at me, look, I know these centrefiners aren't the best solution, but the odd millimetre either way is unimportant. By finding the centre and using the vice rails as a sort of cheap V-block, I can roll the body round until the scribed lines under the centre drill and make the hole accurately enough. This thing's for gripping raw stock, not for aerospace engineering. Getting the threaded hole aligned properly without a nice deep countersink is less than optimal. I'm using a tapered point centre finder almost in contact with the thread, then rotating the workpiece on the vice rails in a feeble attempt to get somewhere near the correct datum point. I know the thing's rotating and it could grab in the hole. I'm being gentle and careful for once, okay? I'm probably within a quarter of a millimetre or so of where the hole should be, and I think that's good enough. The sort of stock I'm holding is going to be hot rolled, mill finished, so it's not exactly high precision. You've heard this 283.748 times before, but if you could click that like button, more innocent and unsuspecting souls will get to see these videos, and it'll make me happy as a happy thing.
Neil, where's your air hose? You missed that chip that was stuck in the brown jollip.
She's not wrong. The hose on the air gun that I use on the lathe mill for blowing away chips has been all abraded and it started leaking. A new one arrives tomorrow. That brown jollop, as Amy so delicately puts it, is CT90, more commonly known as earwax. Marvellous stuff. For material that's less than 16mm across, I've got a set of plug-in collars that fit inside the spider. The amount of steel bar I allow to wave about in the breeze at the back of the headstock without being constrained by a set of outboard rollers is no more than about 30 times the smallest material cross-section. That should be enough to prevent whipping where resonances build up and the unconstrained stock bends and swings at spindle speed. It's a major cause of serious lathe accidents. A 1 meter bar at 2000 RPM would have a tip speed of over 450 miles per hour. The modified spider's already proven to be very useful. If you haven't seen the lantern chuck video, it's up there. Watch it next. Otherwise, try that one.